Okay, we're going to start our last section on montage screencast lectures, and it is on the match cut, which gets pretty interesting when we talk about this. So this will lead us into our making process as well. Match cut, when two images have different meanings, but there's a visual match between either the objects, spaces, compositions, or actions. Now, this will become clearer as I give some examples, but it's really important to keep in mind this phrase, when two images have different meanings. So two distinct objects, spaces, compositions, or actions. Two distinct images. Where there's a visual match between them somehow. Okay, so let's get more specific. So a simple example to talk about is in art. So this is René Magritte, the surrealist painter, where he's using two distinct objects and making them appear to have a relationship. So we start making associations between light and heavy, gravity, air, etc. On the left, another Magritte, where the relationship between the three really is almost exclusively in scale and that they're elongated. And of course, the fish is made elongated when it's not naturally vertical to appear more like the human. On the right, John Hartfield, a collage artist and commercial photographer and activist, really, collage artist, uses these kinds of techniques all the time in mostly to subvert Hitler propaganda. So these anti-Nazi propaganda that was going out in the 1920s, where he uses the smoke from an airplane to create almost anything you want, but in this instant to create skeletons, making the point of what Hitler's engines just create death. Here in the 1980s, you have the artist Mark Tansey, who is very influenced by Magritte, and also using this idea of visual rhyme, or two distinct images that are very different in meaning but look alike. Very similar to the Hartfield using this idea of smoke, but of course the aerosol and the cigarette. And we make all sorts of associations between pollution and cleansing in a cyclical way, but also a mother-daughter relationship, one trying to cancel out or control the other. And on the right, another Mark Tansey, where you have the speed of a rocket next to the slowness of an evergreen. And so this idea of time really captured in one composition. And maybe it's obvious, but Tansey was very influenced by Magritte, but wanted to ground his work not in a surrealist context, but by using just ordinary images from reality. So all of his images are possible. Okay, so a graphic match cut is a match between two objects, two distinct time frames, two distinct locations. So it can be distinctions in time and space as well as objects. So let's look at this classic graphic match cut. So this is Lawrence of Arabia from 1962. And tell me where the match cut is.
How did you do it? You might better ask why I bothered you. Because I'm the man for the job.
I just wonder about that.
Of course I'm the man for the job. What is the job, by the way?
Find Prince Faisal.
Good. And when I found him,
find out what kind of man he is. And find out what his intentions are. I don't mean his immediate intentions. That's Sir Colonel Brighton's business, not yours. I mean his intentions. special made pyramids. They can cross 60 miles of desert in a day.
Oh, thanks, Dryden. This is going to be fun.
Lawrence, only two kinds of creature get fun in the desert. Bedouins and gods, and you're neither. Take it from me. For ordinary men, it's a burning, fiery furnace.
No, Dryden. It's going to be fun.
It is recognized that you have a funny sense of fun.
So, of course, the match cut is in a cut. There's a couple different things going on there. The sort of director's problem is that they're trying to jump in time and space. They're arguing about whether he should even go to the Middle East. And he's trying to convince them that he's the man for the job. And instead of showing all the linear logical narratives between discussing whether he should go and making the decision, getting on the airplane, blah, 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 ending up in there, they just cut from this glowing fire of the match, because he's smoking in their linear narrative, to the sun rising. So from micro, macro fire, but also compositionally, they look alike. And he also blows the match, and it's like the dust in the desert. So you have this a match between the action as well as the visual and the concept of fire. And so a lot of matches going on. So here's a clever way, a really creative way of using associative editing to fill in all this information for your viewer. So a match cut can be a match between actions, and in that case it was blowing, and composition, where the object in the two compositions are alike. But let's look at another example. This is a great example by Alfred Hitchcock, North by Northwest. And watch how the scene changes. This is a very, very clever composition where you have the same appearance of the same background of Cary Grant, but it actually is simply the same color. It actually goes from nighttime blue sky to an interior blue wall, but it's so cleverly cut back and forth between the girl and Cary Grant that compositionally they're doing the same thing, and it looks like that it's a match on action, but it's not. It's a match cut between two actions. So watch what's going on. To further insinuate the point with the train. And if you noticed on that, they actually cut to Cary Grant in the train, if you were watching carefully, and the girl on the cliff, and then back to Cary Grant in the train, and then, of course, when he's pulling the girl up, that she's actually in the train. Okay, so a graphic match cut, when an object and two shots graphically match, often helping to establish a strong continuity of action and linking the two shots metaphorically, or telling huge gaps in a story. So the train is kind of a metaphor, but the pulling of the arm is the continuity of action. If you were listening, he called her Mrs. So we skipped the whole wedding. And, you know, that wasn't sort of significant. Just get straight to the happy ending. So again, a match between two objects, a match between two compositions, and a match between two actions. So this should be clear to you now. And now we're going to look at the most famous graphic match cut in history, considered the most famous match cut. And that is from 2001, A Space Odyssey. And we're going to look at a cut that's between both an object, most primarily an object, and you'll see how the object will change in scale from almost micro to vastly macro, like outer space. It also is a match in time between the most primitive primary first tool and the latest, at the time, Star Wars weapon of mass destruction and science. Well, but also what's really an amazing craft is the composition and how those compositions line up. So pay attention to the craft of how they make this cut work. Oops. Okay, so super clear what's going on in there. The angle of the bone and just flowing right into that space, Star Wars space station image, satellite image. Okay, so visual rhyme cut when an object composition or action graphically match but have different meaning, such as in 2001, A Space Odyssey. So you have different times, different space, different meaning, different scale that you're trying to deal with, but you create the same object, composition, action, and motion. So sometimes you use one of these things, but what makes this such a famous match cut is that they use all three of these things in one sequence. And because time and space is about as diverse as you could possibly be. So for our assignment, two things. One is for the next class period, please download and answer the following questions for the montage screencast lecture quiz. It's just about 6 or 7 questions about the films you just saw and about the type of cuts they are. And bring that to class, and I'll collect them at the beginning of class. And look on your Blackboard site for the homework listed right here. So here, the homework is to create a storyboard, 5 pairs of frames that create 5 match cuts and or graphic match cuts. So you want 2 images and objects that look alike that have different meanings. So what you want is a side-by-side frame. So one frame on the left has a rock, the frame on the right has a cloud, and they look alike. And then you want 2 compositions that look alike but have different scale and meanings. So here, maybe an example that we saw was the light switch. Very micro shot, and the buildings with lights on them. Of course, there is some meaning there, but 2 compositions that look alike, or like the match with the sun. 2 actions or motions. We saw that over and over. So Cary Grant bringing the woman up into the train, the bone falling and becoming the satellite. But you also saw it in Doug Atkins over and over, where somebody's even slowly opening their eye and someone else is completing the opening of an eye. But really, you want distinct actions or motions if possible. Create 2 or more compositions from any of the list above. So you'll have 5 side-by-side frames. And look on look on Blackboard to see the exact date when this storyboard. It will be 10 drawings altogether, 5 pairs of drawings of these side-by-side compositions. So hope you enjoyed some of those films, and I will see you in class.